Okay, Romario, for your reference, this is exercise 13.1 in your syllabus. If you remember watching the soft field landing approach that I did back at base, the flapless approach is essentially that in that power adjustments are used to maintain the descent path rather than adjusting the attitude of the aircraft.
Thank you, Roger.
Can have the aircraft trimmed for 70 knots at base. Funnel approach 65. But because we are flapless, a shallower round out will be required. And because we are travelling that much faster than a flapped approach, we'll need a longer float and a longer landing run. So we need to take all those considerations, which means at this particular airport we need to be touching down soon after the numbers, or we get ourselves in a go around situation. So are you happy with all that?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we'll use the grass 1-2 for this exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Actual fact, let's use the reciprocal because of the winds. Okay, the flapless approach and landing exercise 13.1. Base leg 70 knots, 70 knots in the base turn. Thank you. Okay, we're downwind. We can start going through bump fix checks, brakes, undercarriage fixed, mixture check, full rich, instruments check.
Yep, I'm here.
Okay, the flapless approach sequence. There you go, aircraft trimmed 60 knots. Sorry, 70 knots. Maintain 70 knots. If you find that you're slightly high, as we look like we might be here, you can put some small turns to lose the height. Just trim the aircraft and maintain the 70 knots. There you go, we're in.
Sound resumed. Sound muted.
And that is the shortest runway on this field.
Yeah.
Right, have two attempts at that. It's going to start getting dark soon. We need to start heading back to Aviemore. Essentially what you're doing here is what you did the other week, PFLs, but actually making the landing. And that's the advantage of operating somewhere like here and not an airport like Biggin or Rochester, or, you know, these remote fields are perfect for training. Go ahead and load up the VA FS flight. You have control, get the aircraft taxi all the way to the numbers, get the aircraft turned around. Let's go.
ready to go.
You've just eaten that valuable runway, turning around. You won't make it out there. Make a 180, turn back. Keep going, I'll tell you when to make a 180. Right, you're good there, make a 180. Let's go. Right turn out after departure, please. Go straight to downwind. Take up a heading of about 050, you're a bit crabbed. Keep climbing, full power. Heading 040. Full power climb. Keep climbing up to 2000. And then only come back to 23,000 RPM. Okay, Romario, come to a heading of 150 for me, please. Give you a nice long glide. fly heading south. Make a right turn towards the field now. And you're on your own from here. I'm looking for a flapless 70 knot approach once you're established on final. That speed off. Trim the aircraft to bleed the speed off. Don't feed any power in, just establish yourself in a 70 knot glide. Trim the aircraft to do that so you're not working. Very good. Very good, Romario. Start trimming that nose up. You know what, Romario, I'm clapping my hands for you right now. That was marvellous.
Thank you.
Back to the starting point, please. Right, I'm not going to have you do a second approach. We'll touch. We'll continue 13 tomorrow until you've got this nailed. I'm going to show you a glide approach and landing. I'm going to demonstrate a glide approach and landing, and then you're going to fly me back to base.
Roger, roger.
With a short field takeoff. So keep rolling forward. Keep the aircraft on the roll. Keep the aircraft on the roll. Pass me control on the roll, please. Set 10 degrees flat for me, please. Right, as I said yesterday, the aim of the short field or soft field takeoff and landing is where the field length or restriction or the surface is soft due to grass, mud, snow, slush, etc. Max power 10 degrees of flap. Check RPM, T's and P's in the green, and happy with all that, release the brakes, take off. Because you're putting so much power through the engine on the brakes, be ready for the nose to raise at 50 knots. Climb away at 55, best angle for obstructions as well. So, for example, if you've got an obstruction that you need to clear, then if your aircraft will fly at 50 knots, then fly at 50 knots. Right, can you get on the brakes for me, please?
Say again?
On the brakes, please. Press the brakes. Foot brake. Release. So I've got the stick back, aircraft slide. Here we go, we're up, we're in ground effect. And clear of the obstacle. Let's get good forward speed again before those flaps go back up. Flaps up, please. Right, the aim of the glide approach, Romario, is simply to teach. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Approach and landing from any predetermined position without the use of power. For example, unlike the PFLs, we can actually make a landing. So, I just need to reorientate myself. There's the field. Got the field. And with the glide approach, you can use flap as required. I am high on this glide approach here. So already, one stage of flap going in. One stage of flap, please. Thank you. Second stage of flap. I can afford to go full flap. Full flap is going to increase the drag, and I'm going to need a steeper descent rate to maintain the same speed. So as you can see, having full flap there on that glide approach has really helped me out on final, just by predetermining my position and the flap setting that I need. Okay, let's go and get some fuel. We'll head back to base. We'll take half a tank of fuel again. Romario, you have control, let's get back to base. You go. Be ready to track the 261 radial outbound.
I'm ready.
Thank you. Romario, we'll have you do a flapless approach and landing back at base, please. We should get back just before it gets dark. Remember, we've got no runway lights there.
Yep.